Hey guys, welcome back. I have another skincare reaction video. This one is in honor of The Hills being rebooted and coming back. So we're gonna look at Kristen Cavallari. She is on Harper's Bazaar, Go to Bed With Me. You guys know I love that series. I'll leave a link below in the description box with the original video. And let's get started.
It's time to get unready with me. Okay, so the first step in my nightly routine is to take off my makeup, of course. So I use Neutrogena makeup wipes. I've been using these for years and years, honestly, as long as I can remember, because they truly take off everything. I have on foundation right now. I have on a little eyeshadow. So I come in here and I just go to town. There is no better feeling than taking off your makeup at the end of the day. I mean, you guys can see. That's disgusting. Make sure you get your neck. Sometimes I'll take foundation and just blend it. So I wanna make sure that I get all of that off. Okay, so the next step is actually washing my.
So we know that these wipes have like taken over the world. She said there's like nothing better than, you know, removing all your makeup at the end of the day and it takes everything off, but it's like, it doesn't really take everything off. It just smears it all around. So it makes it seem like you took it off. And while you might see some of it on the makeup wipe, you're not really removing all of your makeup. And instead, you guys saw, I mean, she started getting really rough in there. She's like rubbing around. She even turned a little bit pinkish here and stuff. You know how I feel about makeup wipes. I'm just not a fan. I wish we would get rid of them. I have nothing against the brand. So many brands have makeup wipes. We just happen to see the Neutrogena ones often, especially in these videos. But for me, it's kind of like, why does everyone want to use wipes? Wipes are so commonly used. It's pretty amazing. The more that we watch these videos to see how many people use wipes.
My face. So I have a Tatcha rice polish and it's the deep kind because it gets really foamy and I love it because it feels like it just cleans out all of my pores and gets off any makeup that I left behind. I'm in New York right now, so I have the little travel size, but this goes everywhere with me. Since I only wash my face at night, I want to make sure that I really get in there and just get all the crap off of my face. Get all these suds going here. My husband tells me I make such a mess when I wash my face, and I do. My face feels incredibly clean. I just feel like I've stripped away the entire day. But it does, it gets a little bit dry, so then I always follow it up with my...
All right, so she literally stripped away her skin by using makeup wipes and then going in with that rice enzyme. The rice enzyme I'm actually really cool with. I love a good rice enzyme. It's a gentle exfoliator. The problem is I find it very hard to believe that if she had mascara or any of that kind of eye makeup on, that the makeup wipes actually removed it. So I would have preferred that she used an actual cleanser. You guys know I would have preferred that she just did a double cleanse in general, starting with an oil-based cleanser, then moving into a real cleanser, or at the very least using an oil-based cleanser and then moving into the rice enzyme cleanser slash exfoliator. So I wish she would have done something like that. She says, you guys, that her skin feels dry. It gets dry. I mean, she's kind of moving into just drying her skin out. She's not doing anything that's really replenishing it, so she's gonna have to now go through this whole series of trying to replenish her skin, and so that's what I'm assuming we're about to watch happen.
Harry Hayes Retexturizing Cream. This retexturizing cream has TCA in it, so it's really good for anti-aging, and it's also a really thick cream. So I always do like 3 pumps, I get a lot going, take it, and I just completely cover my face with it, and it feels so good. And everything that I do to my face, I wanna make sure that I do to my neck and my chest as well. So the nights that I don't use.
All right, so one thing I wanna point out about Kristen is that she's kind of like, you know, I've noticed like some people are like this, they're like, I just wanna rush through my skincare routine. So she's like, you know, she just rubs it on, she like rubs everything with her towel, she's kind of going for it. Not that big a deal. It's really not that big a deal, but you could always just be more gentle. You guys know I preach that all the time. Treat your skin like it's a baby, you know? It's like you only get your skin once. And while you might not see anything happening to it in the moment, it's what happens later on down the line. It all catches up to you. So baby your skin. And one thing I'll applaud Kristen on is that she said to make sure that she brings all of her skincare down, all the way down to her chest. we haven't really seen that happen in a lot of these videos. A lot of people, I just make the assumption, do it. You know, it's nice to see that she's acknowledging that and bringing it all the way down. As far as this product goes, I have no problem with going straight into a retinoid like that. You guys know I'm a big fan of using retinol at night. Retinoids in general are just great for your skin. They're great for anti-aging. This one looks like it's a really nice one. It also has vitamin E in it to help soothe your skin, so it's a really good product. This can serve as your serum, so you don't really need much else, especially at night. So I'm curious what else she's gonna put on after this.
The retexturizing cream. I actually use a retinol, and this is one by Revision. I am very much a hippie in a sense where I don't eat a lot of processed foods. I'm very natural. This is the one area of my life where chemicals come into play. I have my Tatcha. Again, I have a little travel.
All right, so I was a little bit confused by that. I was like, is she gonna put this on right after she put that retinol on? And then she still was like, on the nights that I'm not using the retexturizing cream, I'm using this retinol. And while I do think it's okay to use retinol every night, because retinol on its own is usually not that strong, especially if you've built up a tolerance. What I'm guessing is she was told that the retinoid in the retexturizing cream is a little too strong to use every single night. So what I'm guessing is someone told her that she could then use the retinol from Revision on the nights that she's taking off, like she's giving her skin a break from the TCA retinoid that she's using in the retexturizing cream. The thing that's a little confusing to me though is that 1% retinol is still pretty strong for over the counter. It's the strongest you can get for over-the-counter of retinol, and so while she's trying to give her skin a break, she's not really giving her skin a break. Does that make sense? So like she's actually just going like really strong retinoid to really strong retinol, and so I'm assuming that she's just doing this every single night, and while her skin actually looks great, it looks really clean and clear and pretty smooth from what I'm looking at, it's probably because of these two products that she's using. She probably has built up a tolerance to it because that didn't seem to affect her skin whatsoever. So that's just something to keep in mind. Just because she's doing it, it doesn't mean that you can do it exactly. You have to definitely build up a tolerance to this. Some people do it and some people can like use a retinol every single night. I personally can't. I can't right now in general because I'm pregnant, but even when I'm not pregnant and I'm using retinols, the reason why I go for retinols is because I find them to be a little bit more gentle and I can use them a little bit more throughout the week, but I still usually go like 4 or 5 days on and then like put in something else like a vitamin C as my active ingredient. But some people can build up a tolerance to using a retinoid or a retinol every single night.
Eye cream with me. This eye cream is really thick. Unless an eye cream is thick, I don't want it because I want it to feel like it's really doing something. So I just take it and I put it, of course, under my eye, but then I kind of go above and just kind of all over. My husband Jay does like to actually steal my eye cream sometimes. He can go honestly months without washing his face. He'll never have a breakout. I would have full acne if I did that. I didn't even think twice about eye cream until I was in my later 20s. And really when I became a mom, us moms know how important eye cream is because we're tired. Sleep will never be the same once you have kids. Eye cream is all.
Absolutely true. Sleep will never be the same when you're a mom. You sometimes get sleep, you sometimes don't. I don't remember sleeping last night. You guys know I actually don't personally use eye cream at night, but I actually understand why she would use eye cream at night and why she wants something that's thick. She didn't really use like a hydrating or moisturizing cream on her skin. She used a retinol cream, which again, the retexturizing one that she used has vitamin E in it, so it's soothing, but it's not necessarily there to moisturize her skin. So if she wants that moisture around her eyes, she does need an eye cream because the retinol is just gonna work on her wrinkles and help her with acne and unclogging her pores and all that stuff, but it's not going to stop the dryness that might happen. And she mentioned in the beginning of the video that she has dry skin. She tends to get dry skin, and it's probably because she's, I'm going to make the assumption, not gonna use a moisturizer. You never know, she might use a moisturizer. If she's not gonna use a moisturizer, it makes a lot of sense why she wants a thick eye cream, and this is exactly when she would use it.
Also great for filming my show. Before I put makeup on, I always put eye cream on as well so that throughout the day as I'm filming, my concealer and the powder doesn't get all cakey. All right, so after I do.
And that's exactly why I use eye cream during the daytime. It's because I don't want my shadow and my concealer to get really cakey around my eyes. So I use a really pretty thick eye cream as well, and that's during the daytime.
My eye cream, I have an herbivore. It's a facial oil. I actually sell these in my store in Nashville. This is the travel version. even though it's for your face, I tend to stay away from oil on my face because I am prone to breakouts and clogged pores. So I take it and I put it all over my neck and my chest. And you know, I'm 32 years old. I just started giving love to my neck and my chest. So I may regret that later, or hopefully I can reverse all of it now or keep all of the aging at bay. Of course, at night, brush my teeth.
So they didn't show her actually applying it to her neck and her chest. I really love that she's acknowledging that, you know, she only just started giving love to her neck and her chest. She hopes it doesn't catch up to her later. But if it does, you know, like she's trying to reverse it. I love that she's mentioning that kind of stuff. What's interesting is the oil that she used by Herbivore, the Blue Lapis one, is actually made for oily skin, which is kind of funny. You guys know I don't love face oils. I personally think that they can be just unnecessary. Like I use them to, you know, whenever I'm doing something like gua sha or like using a jade roller or something, I'll put an oil on my face then. Or like if I'm traveling, if I want something a little bit thicker and I'm gonna get on an airplane, I might set all of my skincare with an oil. But as far as it making you break out, there are oils that can make you break out. Don't get me wrong. But this one's actually made for oily skin. It's meant to help moisturize your skin and soften it. The funny thing is she didn't put anything that's hydrating on her neck and her chest. And so that's something to keep in mind, you guys. Oil doesn't hydrate your skin. It softens and it moisturizes at the very most, but it doesn't hydrate your skin. And there's a big difference. Hydrating is, it needs to have that humectant, that water. If you're putting an oil there, you're just soothing the skin. You're not necessarily hydrating the skin. And so she probably wants to do something like that. She probably should put some kind of a hydrator first and then put the oil. It's not gonna break her out though if she were to try to put it on her face. It might actually calm her skin down, especially after using such strong retinols too, or retinoids. Also, she's confirming, because she's about to head into her toothpaste, that she's not gonna put a moisturizer or anything like that on her face after using the retinol. You don't have to. If your skin is perfectly fine, you've got like normal combination skin, something like that, and your skin doesn't feel like it's dehydrated when you use a retinol, you don't actually have to put anything on. Sometimes I have different retinols that I use that don't end up needing some kind of moisturizer because it moisturizes enough or it's creamy enough. That said, again, she mentioned that her skin is dry in the beginning. It gets really dry. And she does use that eye cream to help balance that out. So I almost think that she would benefit from adding some kind of a moisturizer as the very last step of her skincare routine, because it sounds like she does need a little bit of moisture. And she's talking about like the eye cream in the morning with her makeup and all that kind of stuff. So she's very aware that her skin gets dry, but I'm not sure if she realizes that she's causing it to get dry by using a retinoid and a retinol every single night. So I think that maybe if she just found like a really nice, very gentle moisturizer, she'd find that her skin wouldn't be so dry.
So I use a Tom's fluoride-free natural toothpaste. Has to be minty, always. And then I follow it up with a chapstick. And I have one here from a brand called Sulwhasoo? Sulwhasoo? I don't know, but it works great. Really, really hydrating. It just feels really good. I find that my lips get chapped a lot, especially when I'm traveling. All right, you guys. So that's it. Thanks for getting unready with me.
All right, that was actually a really fast one. She then throws in that her lips get really, really chapped, especially when she's traveling and stuff. You know, when you're putting on a retinol or a retinoid cream like that, it does travel to your lips too, so it will dry out that area. This serum stick by Sulwhasoo is a really nice one. It's a serum though, so that's something to keep in mind. She still needs something kind of occlusive to keep her lips from getting dry after using it. So even if she just threw on like an Aquaphor really quickly over her lips afterwards, it would benefit her even more, because this is, like I said, it's just a serum. So it's gonna help nourish her lips, but then she needs something to really keep that hydration on her lips. So that's just one thing to keep in mind. Obviously, I would ditch the makeup wipes in the beginning. I already said that, you guys know me. I would love for her to do a double cleanse. She'd be a great candidate for it. Most people are. So that would be an oil-based cleanser and then going into a regular cleanser, like a gel cleanser. She could probably use that rice enzyme cleanser in its place as her second cleanse. It probably be totally fine because then she would have melted all her makeup off anyway, and then it would just get it all off and help slightly exfoliate. But as far as the rest of it, it's totally fine. It's totally fine to have a very simple routine. You don't have to have something that's super elaborate and has 10 to like 15 products in it or something. Sometimes we see such elaborate skincare routines, it gets in our minds that we need all of this. You really just need the right ingredients and products. And for her, at night, it's kind of the way I like to go too. It's using a retinoid or a retinol. For her, it's every single night. For me, it's completely different because skincare is personal. And if you're dabbling with retinols and retinoids, I would recommend that you try to ease into it and not try to go full force every single night right away, just because you want to make sure your skin can handle it and it's not too strong for your skin, because it can be a little bit drying and it can be peeling. It does sound like it dries her skin out though, so on top of that eye cream that she uses, I would like to see her use a moisturizer, even if it's a light one. And then I'd like to see her use some kind of a humectant under that oil that she uses on her neck and her chest, because she'd benefit greatly from that. She'd actually get some hydration. Other than that, I think she did a great job. Her skin looks amazing. I mean, she really does have very nice skin. Retinol does that to your skin, you guys. Retinol is, if there's any active ingredient that I think most people should put into their skincare routines, it is a retinoid. Just some kind of retinoid. Retinols are retinoids, but retinoid is like the all-encompassing word for it. So, you know, finding what works for you and figuring that out. It's great for acne, it's great for declogging your pores, it's great for anti-aging. Retinoids are awesome, so I highly recommend it. So that was Kristen Cavallari. I hope that you guys learned something. I hope it was informative. If you have anybody else you want to suggest, tell me in the comments below. We can talk more about this routine too. You can find me on Twitter where I give some advice on skincare as well. It's at Susan Yara. You can find me on Instagram too, same name. And I will talk to you guys soon. Bye.